As authorities continue to investigate Tuesday's tragic shooting in New Jersey, victims were laid to rest Wednesday night.
This as the shootout is sparking new fears over anti-Semitism, which President Trump is trying to suppress. Anna Koyman has details.
A community coming together Wednesday night to bid an emotional goodbye to two of the three bystanders who were killed Tuesday when two armed suspects exchanged gunfire with police for hours in the streets of Jersey City, New Jersey. Hundreds of people gathered Wednesday night for the funerals of 24-year-old Moshe Deutsch and 31-year-old Mindy Ferenz.
They're very, very good people.
Tuesday's gun battle and standoff ended at a kosher market and left a total of six people dead, including veteran police detective Joseph Seals, three bystanders inside the store, and suspects 47-year-old David Anderson and 50-year-old Francine Graham. Authorities haven't determined a motive, but the city's mayor believes the location was targeted in an anti-Semitic attack, sparking fears of more attacks on the Jewish community.
Isn't a person that's not affected of it. Everyone is like literally scared to walk on the road.
President Trump weighing in on the tragedy at a Hanukkah reception at the White House.
With one heart, America weeps for the lives lost. With one voice, we vow to crush the monstrous evil of anti-Semitism whenever and wherever it appears.
A few minutes later, the president signing an executive order aimed at combating anti-Semitism on college campuses. Officials say the two shooters in the rampage are also the prime suspects in the killing of an Uber driver in nearby Bayonne, New Jersey. In New York, Anna Koyman, Fox News.